नमस्ते, हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड ऑल व्यूअर्स, होप यू ऑल आर वेल एंड यू आर एंजॉयिंग आवर क्लासेस एंड यू आर फॉलोइंग आवर क्लासेस टू. ओके, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर क्लास फॉर टुडे. यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट बेस एंड हाइट ऑफ द ट्राइंगल, बेस एंड हाइट ऑफ द पैरेलल लाइन, एंड देन आफ्टर वी हैव रिटन टू फार्मूला फॉर एरिया ऑफ द ट्राइंगल्स. Area of the triangles when height and base of the triangle is given, and area of the triangles when all three sides are given. This must we have discussed yesterday. Okay, now today we go ahead. Yesterday what we have discussed, that suppose this is the triangle, this is the triangle ABC. If this is perpendicular to this, then this is the height and this hole is base. Similarly, suppose this is a parallel line, this two parallel line, the perpendicular distance of this line is the height of the parallel line, and also the height of all the figures which are inside the parallel lines. So this much we have discussed about what is the height of the triangle, base of the triangle. There are many different cases to recognize height and base of the triangle. Similarly, height of the parallel line and all the figures inside the parallel line. And also yesterday what we have written, the formula area of triangle equal to 1 by 2 base into height, or 1 by 2 in short b into h, when base and height of the triangle are given. Similarly, we have written another formula, area of triangle is equal to under root s minus a s minus b and s minus c, where s is the semi perimeter, p by 2 or a plus b plus c by 2, where a, b and c are sides of triangle. So yesterday we have discussed this much. Okay, today we go ahead. What is the height of the triangle, base of the triangle? What is the height of the parallel line or inside or the figure inside the parallel line? Area of the triangle is 1 by 2 base into height, and or 1 by 2 BH. Area of triangle S minus A, S minus B, S minus C, when the sides of the triangles are given. Now we go for equilateral triangle. This is the basic formula of triangle. We can find out area of the triangle of any triangle, either it is right angle triangle, acute angle triangle, obtuse angle triangle, equilateral triangle, isosceles triangle, or obtuse or scalene triangle, any triangle. These are the two basic formula for finding the area of all kinds of triangles. But sometimes we need a sort in mathematics and science, so we derive sort formula for equilateral triangle. So we are going to now derived area of equilateral triangle. What is an equilateral triangle? See here, this is an equilateral triangle. Suppose these three are equal. An equilateral triangle is a triangle in which all sides are equal and all angles are of 60 degrees. This is the equilateral triangle. Suppose the length of this equilateral triangle is L, or you can say S also, but say L. If this is L, then all three are L. And now suppose we have to find out area of this triangle. To find out area of this triangle, we can find by using that this formula: S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. Okay, by using this formula we can also find out area of this equilateral triangle. But sometimes we need faster to get faster and faster. If we use this formula, it takes times, but if we derived all the formula for finding area of the equilateral triangle, then it will be very easy for than this one. So we are going to find out easy formula for only for equilateral triangle, okay? But by we use same this concept. So it is equilateral triangle. The side is L. You can take 3, 4, 5 centimeter or A or S, anything. I'm taking here the length as L. If this is L, then all are L. We are going to find. We are going to use this formula for finding equilateral triangle. So by using this formula, first of all, we need what? We need S, or we need ABC. What is ABC? A is the opposite side of angle A. A is the opposite side of, means this is angle side A. BC is called side A, which is L. What is B? B is the side, small b is the side opposite angle of B. That is AC is equal to B, that is also L. Similarly, what is small c? Small c is the side which is opposite to the angle C. That is AB. AB means small c, that is also L. So we have found here ABC. Now what we need? We need S. S means semi-perimeter. We know semi-perimeter S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2. Here, what is the value of A? That is L. Value of B is also L. Value of C is also L. Put at the value L plus L plus L divided by 2 will get 3L by 2. This is the semi-perimeter of this triangle. Now, to find area, we use this formula. So, come this side. Now, area of the triangle is under root S, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. Now put the value. We have value of A, B, C here, and we have value of S here. What is the value of S? So we have 3L by 2. Similarly here also, 3L by 2, value of A is L. 3L by 2 minus value of B is L. Similarly, L means 3L by 2 minus C is L. So we have put here the value of S, A, B, C. Now simplify this. 3L by 2 keep here as it is. If we simplify 2LCM, 2L minus, sorry, 3L minus 2L. Same way also here also, take LCM 3, 3L minus 2L. 3L minus 2L. Again, 3L upon 2 keep as it is. If we get subtract 3L 2L from 3L, we will get L upon 2. Here also we get L upon 2. Here also we get L upon 2. Now again simplify it. If we multiply all numerators, we get 3 L L L L L to the power 4. Similarly, if we multiply this one, 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16. And again, write in simplest form, the square root of 3 is square root. Square of 3 is square root 3. Square root of L power 4 is L square. And square of 16 is 4. So this is the formula to derive area, to find area of an equilateral triangle. This is the simplest formula for equilateral triangle. But we use only in equilateral triangle, not in other triangle. But this formula of area of triangle is used, can be used in any type of triangles where all sides are given. So when suppose we are given equilateral triangle, we can use this formula to find out area, or we can use directly this formula. If we use directly this formula also, we can get the same value. So when we need faster, then we use this formula. Okay, so this is the formula of area of an equilateral triangle. I think you are getting me. Okay, so what we have derived here, we have derived the area of an equilateral triangle. There are other ways also to find the area of equilateral triangle, okay, but today I am doing this one only. And what is the perimeter of equilateral triangle? Sum of all sides. Perimeter means sum of all sides, or sum of all boundaries, or sum of all outer edges of any plane figure. So if you all three sides, you will get the value of perimeter of equilateral triangle. Now we are going to start quadrilateral. To find area of quadrilateral. So first of all, what is quadrilateral? A quadrilateral is a closed figure bounded by four lines. Again, what is quadrilateral? A quadrilateral is closed figure bounded by four lines. By the definition, this is a quadrilateral. It is a closed figure and bounded by four lines. You can write here A, B, C, D. I am always writing A, B, C, D. You can write whatever you like, P, Q, R, S, T or anything. A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral here. Now we have to find out area of the quadrilateral. We can find out perimeter very easily by adding this A, B, B, C, C, D and D, A. If we add all four sides, we will get perimeter of this quadrilateral. It is not, it is very easy. The main thing is how to find the area of the quadrilateral, okay? And remember one thing, that if only four sides, the value of only four sides is given, we cannot find out area of the quadrilateral. To find area of the quadrilateral, one more thing can be given. Suppose we have given this line. This line is called, what is this line? This line is called diagonal. What is diagonal? The line joining of opposite vertices of a quadrilateral is called diagonal. And there are two diagonals in any quadrilateral. We have joined these two opposite vertices, then BD is a diagonal. Similarly, if we join A and C, then we get another diagonal AC. In any quadrilateral, there are two diagonals. So to find out area of the quadrilateral, we must have given one diagonal. Suppose we have given this side, 3 centimeter or 4 centimeter, 5, 6, 7. Then only we can find out area of this quadrilateral. Suppose we have given this side, this side, this side, this side, and also the value of this diagonal, then we can find out the area of this quadrilateral. How we can find out? See, this diagonal divides the quadrilateral in two parts or two triangles. Diagonal BC divides the quadrilateral ABCD in two parts or two triangles, that is triangle ABD and triangle BCD. There are two triangles here. So if we find area of this triangle and area of this triangle by using this formula, S minus A, S minus B and S minus C, we can get area of this triangle. And we can get area of this triangle by using same formula. And if we add both area of the both triangles, we will get the area of quadrilateral. what? If we have given four side of the quadrilateral and one diagonal, at that time we can find out the area of the quadrilateral by by finding the area of these two triangles by using this formula, because we have all three sides of the triangle, this triangle, all three sides of this triangle. So we can find out area of these two triangle, and last, if we add both the triangles area, we will get the area of quadrilateral. Okay. This is the one way to find out area of the quadrilateral. But sometimes what happened that we are not given these sides. We have not given these sides. We have given this diagonal, any one diagonal, either this diagonal or this diagonal, and a perpendicular distance from the vertex to the diagonal. Same way here also. Perpendicular distance. Okay. Sometimes we have given this value of this diagonal, value of this, value of this. Then we have to find out area of the quadrilateral. So how we can find out area of the quadrilateral? This is diagonal, suppose D. From here to here, this is D. This is, suppose, perpendicular distance, you can write P1 or anything, whatever you like. This is the P2. So in this condition, how can we find the area of this quadrilateral? So again, same thing. This diagonal divides the quadrilateral into two parts, to triangle ABD and triangle BCD. Again, we find area of this triangle and area of this triangle and at the area of both triangles. Okay, but formula is different. In the previous example, what I have given, we have given all sides, value of all sides and the value of the diagonal. That's why we have used at that time under root S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. But we have, in this condition, we have given this line and this line also. If you see this triangle, this line will be the height of the triangle and this line will be the base of the triangle. Similarly, if you see this triangle very carefully, you will get this line will be the height of the triangle and again this line will be the base of the triangle. So process is same, but formula is different. In previous example, we have used SS minus AS minus B formula, but in this condition, we use area of triangle by using half base into it. Okay. So to find area of this quadrilateral, we can write this way: quad ABCD is equal to triangle ABD, ABD plus triangle BCD, BCD. In the in the place of quadrilateral ABC, we can write triangle ABD plus triangle BCD. It is known as in geometry whole part axiom. Whole part axiom. This is the whole and these two are its parts. This is whole part axiom. If we add these two triangle, means this triangle and this triangle, we get this whole quadrilateral. Okay. Now, see, what is the area of ABD? CABD, triangle ABD. In ABD, base is this diagonal. Use formula 1 by 2 into base into height. Here also, in this triangle also, 1 by 2 into base into height. For triangle ABD, write 1 by 2 as it is, and we need base. So in this triangle, what is the base? Yesterday we have discussed about base and height. This is the height and this line is the base. So BD, in the place of B, we write BD into, and what is the height of this triangle ABD? The height of this triangle ABD is this one. You can write AECF, AE. So this is the area of triangle ABD, 1 by 2 BD into AE, 1 by 2 BD into AE. Same way in triangle BCD, write this 1 by 2 as it is. And what is the base of this triangle BCD? What is the base of this triangle BCD? See here, this is the triangle. In this triangle, this line is the height and this line is the base. So again, this BD is the base of triangle BCD also. So in the place of B, we write BD and then into height. What is the height of this triangle? The height of this triangle is CF. In this way, we can get area of triangle ABD and area of triangle BCD. Now, you can put the symbol 1 by 2 in the place of BD. What is BD here? The BD is the diagonal we have written here. The BD is diagonal, so we can write here D into what is AE? AE means this line. We have denoted it by P1. Same way, 1 by 2 into BD. BD is again, it is a diagonal. So we write here diagonal D into CF. CF is P2. P2. Now it is an algebraic problem. See whether in these two part anything common. Here 1 by 2 is also 1 by 2. Here is D, here is also D. So 1 by 2 D is common. 1 by 2 into D is common here. And what remains then? Then here is, here P remains plus here P2 remains. So what we have found here, area of quadrilateral, area of quadrilateral ABCD as 1 by 2 into diagonal into P1 plus P2. 1 by 2 means 1 by 2. D means diagonal of the quadrilateral. P1 is perpendicular drawn on diagonal to its opposite vertex. P2 is also perpendicular line drawn on diagonal from its another opposite vertex. Okay? So this is the way to find area of quadrilateral. If we do this way in every question, it will get longer and longer. But if we do directly this formula, we can get very easily in a very short time. Okay? So this is the formula for quadrilateral. What will be the formula? The formula is area of quadrilateral is equal to 1 by 2 into diagonal and P1 plus P2. This is the formula of area of quadrilateral. You can directly use this formula or you can do by this way. But if you do by this way, you will get some time. Okay. So I know that I believe that you are understanding me, you are getting me how to find out area of quadrilateral. Okay? Okay, thank you. Now, we are going to find area of parallelogram. Area of parallelogram. Okay? First of all, what is parallelogram? I think you know in your previous classes or in your class 8, class 7, class 6. What is parallelogram? A parallelogram is a quadrilateral. It means all the properties of quadrilateral is the properties of parallelogram. A parallelogram is a quadrilateral in which opposite sides are parallel. Again, what is parallelogram? A parallelogram is a quadrilateral in which opposite sides are parallel. Okay? And further properties is its opposite sides are equal also, if its opposite angles are also equal. Diagonal divide the parallelogram into two equal parts. Both the diagonal bisect each other. These are the additional properties of parallelogram. So, before finding the area of parallelogram, we should know the meaning of parallelogram. Parallelogram is a quadrilateral of which opposite sides are parallel. Okay? So, we make here a parallelogram. Suppose this is a parallelogram. A, B, C, D. This side is parallel to this side. This side is parallel to this side. Now we have to find out area of the parallelogram. Okay. And we know that in parallelogram, opposite sides are also equal. It means AD is equal to BC. AB is equal to CD. AD is parallel to BC and AB is parallel to DC. Okay? Yesterday we have discussed that suppose this is a parallel line. If we draw here a perpendicular line, perpendicular distance. If we draw perpendicular distance, then this perpendicular distance will be the height of this parallel line or whole parallelogram. We can draw here also from this vertex. This is a perpendicular distance of these two parallel line. It means this is the height of this parallel line as well as this parallelogram also. So, if we use height as this, then base will be this. If we add this, then base will be this. Okay? So, what is the formula of parallelogram then? Area of parallelogram is equal to, you know, base into height. Base into height. Okay, but why the area of parallelogram is base into height? There is a reason. We can also prove, like we have found the area of quadrilateral, we can also find out area of parallelogram. Why the area of formula of area of parallelogram is base into height? Very simple. Why it is? Again, we can sort parallelogram A, B, C, D right here. Now, suppose this is parallelogram A, B, C, D, and draw one diagonal. Suppose this is the diagonal. The diagonal divides the parallelogram into two equal parts. Triangle ABC plus triangle ACD. Same way, like we have done in quadrilateral. But here, this both area of the both triangle are equal. Okay, what is the area of triangle ABC? What is the area of triangle ABC? Base into height. 1 by 2, base means BC, height means, you can write here H, this is also H, H plus, what is the area of triangle ACD? If you take area of triangle ACD, this will be height and this will be the base. So, 1 by 2 into base, base means AD and height, height means H, okay. Now, 1 by 2, this we have already told that this BC and AD are equal. We can write here BC into H plus 1 by 2. In the place of AD, we write BC into H. Now, see, all are same. If we add these two, If we add half and half, we'll get 1 into BC into H. Now take BC as base. If we take BC as base, then it will be B into H. Therefore, area of palm A, B, C, D is B into H, that is base into height. This is the direct formula for area of parallelogram. My dear students and viewers, I am 100% confident that you are getting me, because you are not commenting anywhere, either in Facebook Live or in YouTube channel. I think you are understanding me very well. Thank you for that you are understanding me very well. And this is all for today's class. From tomorrow, we generate formula for rectangle, square, trapezium, rhombus, kite, and others, trapezium also. So that's all for today. Again, I'm saying there is no homework. You watch this video one time, two times, three times, how many times you like, you can watch. If any confusion is there, you can ask me in Facebook or in YouTube, or you can ask your teacher of your school. Okay? Thank you very much. Have a good day. Bye. Namaste.